Hello, I'm Julia Luber and I play Sarah in Rara Movie.
Hello, I'm Mariana Loyola, I'm her mother, Paula, in the same movie, Rara. Rara is a movie about her point of view, about she have two moms, she's growing up, her body's changing, all the things in her life is changing, and her father took away her and her sister for this mom. It's a nice movie, it's a family movie, it's a very opening movie. Let's go to see.
En la cocina,
¿ah?
Sara, anda a buscarlo, dale.
Yo y Cata pusimos toda la mesa,
pero yo te acompañé con
vos. Bueno, no. Podrías vos también,
no. Es mi día.
Dale, dale.
Servilletas también, hija.
Pero si hay, hay.
¿Qué?
Sí. Dispuesta.
Eso. Dispuesta.
Salud.
The premiere yesterday?
Yes.
How was it? How was the premiere?
Fue muy bonito, muy emocionante. Era bonito ver a la gente, ver la película y era la primera vez que nosotros la veíamos.
It was very, very beautiful and moving to see how other people liked the film and also to see for the first time the entire film as a movie in the cinema.
You had a Q&A afterwards, I guess?
Yes.
How did that go? What were typical questions?
¿Qué fueron las preguntas en la ronda de preguntas y después de la?
¿Cómo fueron las preguntas y respuestas
ayer?
Fueron muy graciosas las preguntas de los niños.
There were some really funny questions yesterday.
Yes, very specific and nice. In, I don't know. It's we laugh.
Yes,
yeah.
Yes.
Some kids ask, where is Kata? She's her sister in the movie. And I don't know, hay palabras que no sé decir bien, pero
hay una.
¿Qué edad tenían? Si los anteojos de Kata eran de verdad. Preguntas muy simples, so simple and so naive.
It was very funny because there were a lot of kids who asked this very simple questions,
yes.
Like, where is Kata? Why didn't she come? Is the glasses she wears, is she really wearing glasses in her real life? How old are you? Do you want to be an actress when you're when you're older?
También porque no era un final.
Porque no era un final feliz.
Yes, they wanted to have a happy ending. Why it wasn't a happy ending? They were wishing it. But it was very nice.
Sí, nice. Y casi la mayoría de las preguntas las hicieron los niños.
Sí.
Yes, it was like the most part of the questions were made by the kids.
By the kids, yes.
Well,
beautiful.
A question that I had when I watched the movie was, where did the idea come from for this movie?
¿De dónde vino la idea?
La idea.
Película.
De la cabeza de Pepa, de Pepa's head, de director head. La película está basada, inspirada, en la palabra, en un hecho que ocurrió en Chile.
The film is inspired in a real thing which happened in Chile.
It's a true story. Inspired. Una jueza lesbiana, se llama Karen Atala, su ex marido le quitó la custodia de sus hijas por el simple hecho de ser lesbiana.
Weil Richterin, ne?
A judge.
she know the name. How's the name?
Karen Atala.
Karen Atala was taken off the custody of her children for being lesbian. Only for being lesbian by her ex-husband.
And
so he won the case, no?
Yes.
The court.
Yes, but 12 years later. Ella tuvo que ir a la Corte Interamericana de Derechos Humanos en Suiza para lograr recuperar la custodia de sus hijas.
Wow. So
12 years later
she went to the International Court of Human Rights in Switzerland to get back the custody of her children.
Y ahí la recuperó. 12 años estuvo
and
en el
won,
caso.
But it was 12 years of the case, like it was a really really long story.
Y Pepa, la directora, toma este caso como una inspiración y hace Rara.
And Pepa, the director, she took the case like an inspiration for the film.
But the difference is the point of view of the movie, it's her hair, you know? It's she conduces the movie. Not my mirada, es la de ella. This is the interesting about the movie, I think.
It's not her perspective, not the mother's perspective, the judge's perspective, but the child's perspective.
It's not
an adult perspective,
it's a child perspective.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm also going to ask about that later, but I would like to stick with the true story behind it for a second. How close did you work together with this judge? Did you actually meet her? Did you talk with her about
the story? No, but I saw many videos and case and paperwork. We all the girls study the case, and Pepa knows her, but they are not close. But tampoco era la idea, como imitarla, o no es una biografía, ¿no? Entonces había que inspirarse un poco en eso y estudiar, y vimos muchos videos, lo que te decía, y leímos mucho material. Yo sobre todo que la interpreto a ella. Pero...
But it was not about being a biopic.
No, it's not a biopic, yes. It's just an inspiration.
Mm-hmm. Well, one of the ideas I had in the movie was to show a very regular family.
Yes.
Wasn't it? That was sort of also one of the ideas.
Yes, yes, absolutely.
Que fue la idea, una de las ideas principales, le parece que fue mostrar una familia muy normal,
sí,
corriente.
Sí. Con mucho amor. Ay, sí. Eso es muy lindo, hay mucho amor.
Yes. Muy acogedora.
It's very beautiful. They both say that there's a lot of love inside the family.
And a lot of life, I feel.
And life,
yes.
It's very nice.
Sí, sí. Yes. Y las niñas lindas, claro, es también era una idea de mostrar que en el fondo una familia es una familia, compuesta por quienes sea. Una familia puede ser un tío y un sobrino, un abuelo y una niña. No es necesariamente el hombre y la mujer.
That a family can be whatever. It can be two men, two women, with children, without children. It can be very many constellations can be a family.
Yes. Y también es una manera de hacer una crítica a nuestro país, en Chile, que todavía no hay ley de igualdad sexual. Somos un país todavía muy comandado por la Iglesia Católica.
Mm-hmm. And also we wanted to make a critic to our own country, where there's still no equality for gender rights or for homosexual relations, and where the country is still very much ruled by the Catholic Church.
Yes. Y es muy estructurado Chile, very, very...
Structured?
Yes, structured and... ¿cómo se diría? Como muy clasista, tradicional. Nuestro país.
Very traditional, classistic country.
Por lo mismo creemos que esta película le va a hacer muy bien a nuestro país.
And that's why we think that this film will do very good for our country.
Es una película familiar también, es cierto. Y está bueno que se hable, ¿no? La familia de estos temas y que se... Desde la mirada de los niños también, desde esa simpleza, entregarle a los papás esta visión de que el amor es una fuerza que une y que no es más.
It's very important, also to have this like a kind of a discussion in the families who could see the movie, that the most important thing is love, no? That this is the thing which unifies a family, nothing else, no?
Yes.
Yeah, and well, you already said sort of that it's a family movie. I mean, that is also...
Yeah, I think that, yes.
Yeah,
absolutely.
The perspective of the child, I mean, that was very important in the movie. And you said that it was also giving a certain simplicity to the view. How did you get there? How did you decide to have this view? And how was it for you, especially, to be sort of the center from which everything is shown?
¿Cómo se decidió de tomar la perspectiva de la niña como protagonista para contar toda la historia? Es una pregunta. Y la otra, ¿cómo fue para ti, especialmente, ser el centro de la película?
Ser la protagonista.
Sí, fue muy como importante en mi vida, como que... me ayudó mucho, agarré más personalidad también, aprendí muchas cosas, me metí en un personaje, aprendí cosas de ese personaje, iba viendo cómo poder hacerlo y me ayudó mucho en general, como en la vida. Sí.
Wow, it was a very, very important thing for me to have this role of Sara, ¿no?
Sara.
Because it like helped me also develop own things which first happened to the figure Sara in the film, but I had like to confront them myself, and that's why how I grew also with the role. It was very important, very good for me.
The central idea, I think, is that the head, I insist, is the head of Pepa, directora, the director, you mm-hmm. know. But I think this particular view of her, it's about she doesn't have ¿cómo se dice prejuicios?
Prejudice
about the homosexuality, and I think she doesn't do a movie about lawyers or judges or a big movie and an adult movie. She always want to make a child movie, and I think this is why this picture is so I don't know the word, annoying? It's not annoying. It's tan adorable. Mm-hmm. It's so adorable, the picture, mm-hmm. I think. Y Pepa, it's a child inside, I think, too. Sí, nos reímos mucho. We laugh a lot in the movie, and the child, I think they feel very comfortable with us, the old crew. It's so nice.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, God. Oh, I'm flipping. A ver, vení.
Cosita.
Hola, precioso.
Mira sus patitas.
Hermoso.
Mírate.
¿Por dónde habrá entrado?
Tendría que estar la gata por acá.
Sí.
And I guess the kid's perspective was also a way to avoid mm-hmm. this structured view that maybe would have come with an adult in the center.
Yes, I think it's for that, absolutely. Yes, yes. Era porque el punto de vista estaba contado por el niño y no por el adulto.
You were already talking about the situation in Chile a little bit. Maybe we could go a bit deeper there. Like, mm-hmm. how exactly is the situation? There are no laws for legal mm-hmm. marriages, I understood. How are things changing over the last years? Michelle Bachelet is sí. very open, if I understand right.
She's open, but her men around her, no. It's very traditional. The left and the right in my country is the same thing. No sé cómo se dice, todavía estamos bajo la constitución de Pinochet uh-huh, en Chile. Uh-huh.
We are still living under the Pinochet's constitution.
¿Cuántos cambios puedes hacer con esa constitución por detrás? Es muy difícil.
It's not possible to make any changes with this constitution. You're still having.
And ahora tenemos un pacto, no sé cómo se dice en inglés, pacto de unión civil, yeah. PUC.
Yeah. Pacto de unidad civil.
De unión civil, but it doesn't marriage yet.
Yes. No, but it means you have now you have the right to have a gleichgeschlechtliche eheähnliche Partnerschaft.
Ja, yeah, eingetragene Partnerschaft.
Eingetragene Partnerschaft.
Yeah, civil marriage, I think it is.
Civil partnership.
It's pacto.
Civil partnership.
Civil partnership.
Yeah. Something like that. It's an
euphemism. Yes, but still you don't have the right to have a marriage.
Yeah. We doesn't have people. Abortion law too. Oh. We are a country very very traditional and y con una línea empresarial y familiar muy de derecha, muy ligada a la iglesia con mucho poder.
And we have like this class which is governing, which is ruling, and also the whole economic class which is ruling. They are very right-wing people, very very close to the Catholic Church and very close to
very power
traditions, no, also to the militarist
yes.
traditions and
too. It's very difficult, and the actual and the Michelle Bachelet, she's very difficult to para poner sus leyes mm-hmm. o sus proyectos de ley. It's very difficult for her.
Mm. But it's very difficult for Bachelet, because even if she wants to change something and to put a new law, for mm-hmm. example, to make it real, it has to be approved by Senate mm-hmm. or by
yes.
you know, by different institutions, and they don't work as she wishes,
yes.
no, because they are very much more conservative than she is, so she has not many possibilities to change.
But also the themes now we talk about it in the tables, familiar tables, to the more open mind families or people. It's a little more open, I think, yes, it's true. It's not the enemy of the homosexual people, you know. Hay gente tan estructurada en Chile que lo piensa así, que es como es como un enemigo. Que,
yo tengo un poco de problemas si hablas.
Ah, no, ah, perdón. Es español,
okay. Porque ahora okay. De verdad no entendí.
No importa, no importa. No, bueno. Que es que es lo mismo, es más de lo mismo, no importa. It's okay. No, it's okay. Sorry.
No problem.
Okay.
Well, that was also something that was a little bit in the movie. I mean, you had people like the director of the school, the father, that were very conservative, mm-hmm. very traditional. But in the beginning, there is also a conversation where you talk about the heritage of the dictatorship. Mm-hmm. So that also comes in there. That was, I guess, a hint pointing towards that there still is the heritage alive of the dictatorship in Chile.
No sé, ahí sí. Es que no sé cómo responderlo, porque me habla de la herencia...
De la herencia de la dictadura, sí. De la cual se habla en una de las primeras escenas.
Sí, sí. Es que es lo mismo, es más de lo mismo. Vivimos con esa constitución pinochetista que no se ha podido disolver, uh-huh. y ciertamente con un sistema de gobierno muy ligado todavía a esa dictadura. Un sistema que se llama binominal.
¿Qué significa?
Que significa, no lo tengo claro muy bien, pero es como que son puros enredos, es una constitución muy bien hecha, en uh-huh. ese sentido está llena de candados, uh-huh. porque tiene, no sé, los dos cuartos, los dos tercios del Congreso, uh-huh. si sale esto, no, está muy arreglado para que siga la derecha en el poder.
Uh-huh. Y so lo que es muy difícil, she wants to say that in the sense we are still living with the heritage of the dictatorship, yes. in the sense that this was the structure which still is working today. Mm. So with the laws, with the constitution, and this is a very, very well-made structure.
Yes.
So it's very difficult to change it or to dissolve it, yeah. because they always like they checked everything up that they always can stay in power somehow.
Ha costado 40, ¿cuántos años llevamos ya? O sea, la constitución es del 80, el golpe ya tenemos 40 y tantos años. Y sí o no, sigue costando. Y yo siento que además en la medida en que no se acepte que fue un genocidio, que las cosas sucedieron, que no se hagan monumentos a los caídos o a los detenidos desaparecidos, vamos a seguir siendo una sociedad enferma. No se puede subsanar eso así nomás, yo creo.
Think that, it's very difficult to change something. Meanwhile, we don't accept that it was a genocide, that there are thousands and thousands of desaparecidos.
Sí, detenidos desaparecidos. Vanished people.
Vanished people. And meanwhile, we don't accept this legacy and these mm-hmm. horrors, these crimes. We cannot change the society. And she thinks it's still like without being solved and without being spoken out.
Well, I was wondering how it is for the new generation. I mean, I guess you talked with your friends about being in the movie. How did they react when you told them that you're playing in a movie?
Como para la nueva generación, ¿cómo reaccionaron tus amigas, tus amigos cuando les contaste la película
o cuando haciendo la peli?
¿Qué estabas haciendo?
O sea, me felicitaban, estaban sorprendidos igual que yo y de hecho muchos aparecían de extra atrás, muchas amigas. O sea, yo creo que para mí y para ellas también fue como súper sorprendente todo eso. Mm-hmm.
So they are very happy and they are like surprised as me that I'm taking part in this film and many of them also took part as...
Es su colegio real, de hecho, donde está grabada la película es su colegio.
De hecho, it's her school where the scenes are being played.
And the extras.
Extras? What's extras?
Ah,
English?
Extras, I don't know the word.
The
people.
Statisten, yeah. I don't know in English.
No, I don't know. Extra, I think. Extra, so, I think.
Extras.
I don't know.
Okay.
The extras are her friends, so it was very great. But from the. I think you wanted to ask like more from the.
About the two mothers. The two mothers.
So
to the two mothers.
¿Cómo reaccionaron al tema? O sea, mm-hmm. el tema de que en la película tienes dos madres. Que tienen una relación, etc.
En general, como mi grupo de amigas y toda la gente, en general siempre ha sido un tema normal, o sea, no ha sido un tema como...
Uh-huh,
uh-huh. Habría sido la misma reacción si hubiera sido una película con otro tema o algo así. Como
wow.
Que,
well, it was my friends, it was never an issue. So it's very normal. They don't think it's something which could be more rare than a heterosexual couple. So it was... Everything okay?
Yes.
That's very nice.
Yes.
Well, the premiere is here at the festival, and you already talked a little bit about what you think the reaction could be in Chile. Mm-hmm. Do you know when it's going to premiere there, and what do you think will be questions there?
Oof. I don't know. Maybe, ¿cuándo es la fecha de estreno? Maybe May, June, I don't know, really know. Y lo que creemos que va, claro, ¿cuál va a ser la reacción? ¿Qué crees tú?
Yo creo que va a ser bonita. O sea, va a ser súper bonito estrenarlo allá, donde vamos a estar con todo el equipo también. Yo creo que le va a ir bien a la película. Eso.
Well, Julia thinks that the film will succeed and it will be a very nice premiere in Chile. All the people will be there, the whole team, the whole group.
So. Y es una película que le va a hacer bien, yo creo, a Chile.
Sí.
Va a generar buen contenido.
Mariana thinks that it will do good for Chile. Sí. It will be good film for Chile because it's very critic.
Yes, sí. Yes.
Well, thank you very much for this interview, and I hope you will have a good time here in Berlin and a lot of success with the movie in Chile.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Gracias.
Gracias.